What profession do you have and would you recommend it? Project manager, producer in the tech game industry. Are you the person who plans everything well into the future and down to every detail when group of friends have an outing or go on vacation? Do you plan everything and herd the cats? Do you have no tangible skills but are good at talking to PPL and being a mediator if things get tense? If so, it's probably the job for you. I am 32, pays 90k. Also, don't expect to be thanked. Ever, because the point of the job is to make sure all things go normal and smoothly. So if you're doing your job correctly, nothing is happening. Also, be ready to always be the downer that keeps the dreamers from going too far, and snapping tunnel visioning devs out of it by pulling them away from diminishing return work. Also, you cannot be the kind of person that gets stressed when things go wrong, because things will always go wrong. That's why you have a plan B and C and D. In fact, if the team sees you losing your head, then it's all over. Exploration geologist. Single and love adventure 11/10 would recommend. Looking to settle down and start a family 4/10 wouldn't recommend. On set props and television and film, it's fun. But I work insane hours, and I never see my family. No work-life balance. I interned at a marine mammal rehab rescue facility in Alaska last summer, which is a dream job to many. It was really cool, but also insanely gross. I had no clue seals see lions were that vile. They literally had to warn us 3 times in training. You have to hold your breath if you approach them from the front, because their breath will just about knock you out, and they belch a lot. Didn't listen once, but after I got a hot, humid fassiful of concentrated morning breath, fishy halitosis and bent over retching, I took it a bit more seriously. If you can deal with that, I'd recommend it. Dentist. I love it, but I know many who hate it and can't wait to retire. If you don't mind going to school for a long time and are willing to work hard and really really like helping people, then this may be the career for you. It also helps if you're outgoing and are extremely detailed oriented. Unemployment. Don't recommend it. Pay isn't good, benefits are non-existent, and you feel like a stain on the earth. Hours are good though. Chef. Absolutely not. Under no circumstances. This is not a job for people who love food. If you love food, then take it up as a hobby and you'll be happy forever. This is a job for workaholic masochist adrenaline junkies. Plus, you have to be willing to give up your entire social life and work for crap wages forever. I'm a waitress, and I always wondered if the chefs like it there or not, but this definitely answers that question, lol. I'm a fraud investigator for a large auto finance company. Interesting work, very busy, so time flies. Due to COVID, working from home for the unforeseeable future. When in office, totally casual dress code, so no real work clothing expense. Good work-life balance, and pay is decent. Would recommend 8/10. Tile setter. Absolutely recommend. I charge out at $75 an hour, but make contract prices. I'm not even looking at commercial work. To be fair, I live in a wealthy city. Generally get in $100 an hour or more. It's one of the cleaner trades. My other tradesman friends accuse me of being a hairdresser. It's a finishing trade. It doesn't matter how perfect the drywall is. It's drywall. The love and affection I get from my customers because everything I do is beautiful makes the day. $100 an hour doesn't hurt. Also, I had no original training other than working for another tile setter. Never went to any school, did not pay for training. My cousin's husband is a tile setter. He's good at it, created a name for himself and could have retired at 45, like 25 years in. He's working his last 15 years to pay for their toys and retirement. I decided to be an engineer and have obviously made the wrong career choice. I'm here till 60 plus. My wife would say, if you want to be an artist, don't get a master's of fine arts, become a welder. You'll make a lot more money, and can still make art in your spare time. She has an MFA in metalwork and printmaking. She works for a world-class art museum, as an associate curator, and has been there for 19 years. She wouldn't qualify to be hired for that position now, she need a doctorate. They aren't even hiring secretaries unless they have at least a master's, because there are so many art degree grads out there. I have a high school, and some college education. I make more, don't have to work weekends, and can still make art, too. That is freaking hilarious, and absolutely true. Welding is a kick-ass trade job and makes decent money. Cybersecurity architect. A good well-paying gig if you can get it. But you have to be willing to be constantly learning. High school administrator. Do not recommend unless you like crap from all sides. Waiting for the day I pay off loans and can afford to go back to teaching. I don't know how you do it. Dealing with parents and central office is the worst part of my job, and you mostly deal with the kids when things have gone wrong. I hope you can get back in the classroom soon. I'm a teacher. I like it. I'm pretty good at it. I would recommend it, but you have to be a person that doesn't give a crap about what others think about you. Know that every day is a new day, and you need to be able to speak up for yourself. Also, you need to know this is just a job, not your entire being. Knowing and finding the school that is the right fit for you is important as well. I get my summers off, so it's worth it. I'm a bartender at a small town casino. I would definitely recommend it cause the money is great. But it definitely altered the way I think about the general public, especially older men, cause I was 16 when I started. Yeah, I waited tables at a fairly expensive restaurant with a bar in the middle of Silicon Valley. I definitely don't like men, young and old, as much as I used to after that experience. I work with horses. Very rewarding. But it comes at the cost of wrecking your body. I'm not even 30 yet and my knees, pelvis and hands are falling apart. Very hard work. Very little appreciation from the animals. And I'll never be rich. But I couldn't imagine doing anything else. Having seen your username and job, I'm now curious as to what percent of Marmalade is actually horse. I've been a massage therapist for 25 years. It's exhausting and I hate it. There are no transferable skills that don't require tons of school and still you are in a similar profession. It's fricked. Chemical engineer. Would absolutely 100% recommend if you like solving puzzles, thinking logically, and people. I make more than I need, work with great people, and solve interesting problems. My specific job role can be stressful at times, and I don't like that I often need to take work home. However, my company just went to a 4-day work week, so that balances out the unpaid overtime to me. I work 45 hours a week and make $110k. Comic artist. I get to be funny and creative for a living. But to be fair, I busted my butt working full-time and doing this before it became sustainable. I work as a process analyst. I watch other people do their job, ask them questions about what they're doing and why, discuss what shortcuts they take or would like to take, then write down the steps. Ideally, someone could come in off the street and follow my written instructions to complete the same task. I also update existing instructions as legal requirements change, which involves translating lawyer speak into actual English and figuring out where it will best be included in the instructions. I sometimes either train the new material or teach it to others who train it. The majority of my day, I'm sitting all alone, listening to music and writing or updating copy on my computer. For an introvert with an aptitude for writing, it's an ideal job. It pays decently well and it's rarely boring. I am an archaeologist. I don't know if it's for everyone. Work is very intermittent, like construction. Periods where you're worked very hard with lots of expenses covered, followed by times where there's no work at all. If you live alone, it's hard to find good living accommodations. You certainly won't feel much like getting your own apartment if it means only living there a few months out of the year. Mechanic. Heck no, would not recommend. Every time someone tells me they want to become a mechanic, I try my hardest to convince them not. Wish someone would have stopped me. The automotive field is turning to crap. McDonald's pays more than what a entry-level lube tech would make. Not to mention that thousands of dollars that you have to spend on tools that lose their value almost instantly. Can't forget about the stress and the wear and tear on your body. Used to love cars and working on them. But that was before my hobby turned into my career. 10/10 would not recommend. Cable tech. Yes, I recommend it. Great pay and benefits. No experience necessary. Plenty of challenge if you want. Huge growth potential. Plenty PTO. I love it. Charge nurse in the IQ. Have been RN for 15 years. Up until March 2020, I did encourage nursing as a career. to the point that both of my daughters are in nursing school. After two waves of COVID, I no longer recommend nursing. COVID broke me. I'm currently on stress leave and am looking at what I can do to get out of bedside nursing. My wife has had the same job as you for years and just recently became a school nurse. She has summers off, without pay, but keeps her benefits all year. She was exhausted from 12-hour shifts and her chronically understaffed floor. Audiobook narrator. Work my own hours, from my home. Average about 4 hours of work per day performing, and make a very handsome living from it. 10/10 would recommend. I'm a nurse but I work as a surgical robotics specialist for a large medical device company and 100,000,000% would recommend. I'm a house cleaner. I don't really recommend it unless you are a clean freak. Want to make some money without taxes being taken out. Depends on the company you work for, and want to stay fit without going to the gym. People think it's an easy job, but you have to be very observant. Making sure you try to leave no dust behind. Make sure no wrinkles on the bed sheets, no residue on the counters and stove, not a single crumb on the floor, and make sure you follow the client's orders, or you will lose out on a good connection to other clients. Retail worker. Specifically for a large company, I always say everyone should have to work retail food service for 6-12 months because then maybe everyone would treat those workers better having seen that side. However, I do not recommend it if you can't avoid it. It can be soul-sucking and led to a lot of unhealthy habits. I worked both retail and restaurants for about 3 years each at different points in time. The only thing either of them taught me was how crappy the general population is and how little management cares about the staff for either one. Correctional officer. Or at least I was until recently. No, I wouldn't recommend it at all. Made me totally lose faith in the prison system. It's unbelievable the abuses, punishments some of the inmates have to endure. From each other as well as the guards. I work in state government, and I love my job. My days fly, and every day I'm doing something that matters to help others. Obviously, not every gov job is like that, but many are. And I make enough to support my family, and provide excellent insurance. I'm a veterinarian. Right now, honestly, I wouldn't recommend it unless you are independently wealthy. The student debt is not worth it. If the debt isn't an issue though, the jobs you can have are crazy. You can certainly do small animal general practice, which is what many of us do. But there are vets for production animals, cows, pigs, chickens, etc. Horses, exotic animals, government jobs, health, Department of Natural Resources, epidemiology, even politics, industry jobs like drug or product development and sales. I'm in IT, going on 15 years. I've had a chance to work on some pretty mind-boggling cutting-edge stuff, as well as like, pinball machines and stuff. If you have an aptitude for problem-solving, and aren't afraid to get it wrong a lot, it might be a good fit for the right kind of person. The biggest lesson I've learned is that the whole perception of the IT guy as this dispassionate incomprehensible nerd is something we kind of put on ourselves for various reasons. But the techs who do really well understand that folks don't really need the whole explanation, and you're way better off just fixing it, and having a pleasant human conversation while doing it. I've seen careers rise and fall just based on the ability to like, talk to humans. You never said if you would personally recommend it. Teacher 100% do not recommend. The bulls you have to put up with is beyond belief, much more than the average non-teacher knows about. I was lucky enough to be able to leave the classroom and go into an education-related sector, literacy software, and I absolutely love it. I still get to be involved in helping kids learn, but I get much better pay, much more respect, don't have to deal with bulls from parents, administrators, get to travel, pre-COVID, on the company's dime, work from home, even before COVID, work with a ton of smart people. It's hands down great and I'd recommend what I currently do to anyone. A fun challenge with great rewards. Yes, education adjacent is the move. I do education accounting and I love feeling like I'm making a difference without experiencing any of the BS that teachers go through. Worked as a grief counselor for a hospice 20 years. Recommend. For the right person. Takes an old soul with good boundaries who doesn't give advice. $22 HR. I have a bachelor's in psych but most have master's degrees. My time spent felt worthwhile. One of my needs. Strong team bonding experience. Many co-workers have become lifelong true friends. Workload was heavier than it should have been. Worst part was going into smoky houses. Have worked for both. Non-profit hospices are far better than for-profit ones. If you approach it a certain way, every day provides opportunities for personal growth. Loved it. Wildland firefighter. And no, not for the faint of heart. Hard physical labor, long hours, away from your home and family all summer, all for 15 an hour and you get laid off when it snows. But it's the best thing in my life and I wouldn't have it any other way. I run a snack bar at a bowling alley. I've had many higher paying jobs but I've yet to find one that makes me quite as happy at making folks happy when they eat my yummy food. Land surveyor. And absolutely yes. I would 100% recommend it if you are willing and able to work outside in all kinds of weather and environments. I have been places and seen things that your average person will never get to see or do. It is amazing. The pay is pretty good if you are good. There is a huge shortage right now. You can start with little to no experience and be crew leader in just a few years. I'm a truck driver. Frick yeah, I recommend it. This job is cake and it pays well and it's easy as frick to get into. It's a job that even a homeless person could technically get into. Many mega companies like Swift, CRST, and Schneider will pay to bring you to their training headquarters, put you up in dorms, train you and give you your CDL, then put you in a truck that you can live out of. If there was ever a time to get into the field, now is that time. I had a family member who drove trucks cross country for a couple of years and got out of it and he said it was the most honorable profession he's ever known. Teaching. The education system has plummeted down the drain, especially since COVID. Today alone I got my hair pulled, hit in the head, and scratched. CAD at a machine shop. It's awesome. 3D solid sheet metal modeling and put into drawings for the fabricators machinists. Autodesk Inventor is such an amazing program. I'm a CAD draftsman for an FAA engine repair shop. 2D drawings and 3D modeling can be a ton of fun. Too bad none of the engineers take you seriously. I'm an hour generalist and not really. LOL. It's better to specialize in something like compensation or labor law or training. Water plant operator. Making the water that comes out your faucet. Highly recommended. Very few openings. When someone gets this job, they typically stay until retirement, so not a lot of openings. But water plants don't require a lot of employees. There is typically someone there 24 hours a day. So at one job I work 12-hour shifts. 3 days 1 week. 4 days the next week. Repeat. Everybody works a Saturday or a Sunday, then switch after a while. A few months on day shift, then a few months on night shift, then switch. I'm just getting out of a parallel industry. I want my social life back. I'm a relationship specialist at a payroll company, and I love it. It's essentially client retention. I get to make sure that our clients, business owners, are happy, and don't want to go to a different payroll company. Photography. It's oversaturated right now because everyone thinks they're a professional photographer with their digital cameras. It's especially hard if looking to get editorial or advertising work. Super competitive and you have to almost know someone at an agency or magazine already. Psychologist. Only early in my career but would definitely recommend if you are passionate about it. Although would highly recommend it to do thorough research and talk to people in the profession prior to starting. Lots of study and can be very emotionally draining, especially if you are naturally highly empathetic, but very rewarding in so many different areas if you can learn to have a work-life balance and not take things home. Self-care is not just a luxury or something you do when you have time. It is an essential component of the job. Journalist. Are you objective? Are you impossible to buy or bribe? Are you all about exploring topics that people have yet to even hear of? Do you like spending lots of time proofreading and double-checking? Then this job is not for you. Find something else. Dental hygienist here. Pay is pretty good and hours are good. Plus scrubs are comfy. Private practice I would definitely recommend. Corporate dentistry absolutely not. I'm a hygienist too and I generally like it, but I'm sure my back will be fricked within 10 years. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.